Hello everyone. I hope you all are doing good. So in last class, we were discussing about change management. First of all, I'm going to take a quick revision what I have told you or what I have taught you in last class. Which I told you what is the meaning of change. For any company to survive in the market, they have to keep changing, whether they are product manufacturing company or they are service rendering company. They have to keep changing. If they do not change as per the needs and requirements of the people, the company will be out of the market. I have given you the example of Nokia mobile phone. I told you that around 7-8 years back, Nokia mobile phone was the number one mobile phone selling company in the market. But now, Nokia mobile phone is out of the market. This is because Nokia was using Microsoft system to run the phone. Whereas people have started adopting Android because Android was more user friendly. But because Nokia do not shift from Microsoft to Android, the Nokia phones are out of the market now. So, if you want to grow in market, if you want to survive in market, you have to keep changing. And whenever you bring any change, whenever you try to bring any change, the employees, the people in your organization will get afraid. They are resistant to change. So how you are going to manage that so that the people in your organization start adopting the change? They adopt the change in a positive way and then they implement the change so that the change can be successfully implemented. This we have already discussed in the last class. So, to bring a change, we have to manage that change so that the people can adopt the change and work efficiently. That is change management. Now today, I am going to discuss some real life examples of successful management in business. I'm going to discuss some real life examples of successful change management in business. You all have heard about Netflix. I have taken the real life examples of only those companies of which you must be familiar about. As we all know, Netflix is a digital platform where you can watch lakhs of web series and lakhs of movies. Bachcho, Netflix does not start their business in digital world. In 1997, Netflix was born. Netflix was established in 1997 as a media service provider. Previously, the model offered customers monthly subscription to have movies posted to their doors. What Netflix do previously? They give monthly subscription to people and movies in the form of DVDs were delivered to their. This meant they avoided the late fees which traditional movie rental business imposed upon customers. Now, bachcho, if I talk about 10-15 years back, there was like whenever you want to watch a movie, you go to a DVD shop, they will give you the DVD or rent. For example, rent of one day is rupees 10. Now, suppose if you do not return the DVD for 2 days, you have to pay rent 20 rupees. If you do not return the DVD for 10 days, you have to pay rent rupees 100. So you have to go to the market to take the DVD and you also have to go to the market to return the DVD. Now Netflix at that time, what Netflix did, they said that you do not have to go anywhere. We will post the DVDs at your doorstep and we will take the DVDs from your doorstep. This way, they have avoided the late fees which traditional movie rental business imposed on customers. From the beginning, Netflix proved to be disruptive organization, which was likely resulted in its capability to transform and adapt to the digital world. Streaming began in 2007 for the business and meant subscriber no longer needed to wait for DVDs to come through the mail. So, bachcho, from 2007, what Netflix did, Netflix is make a digital platform. There they have uploaded all the web series and movies. Netflix brings a digital platform and there they uploaded all the web series and movies. Now, people do not have to wait for the DVDs to come through mail. They will take the subscription and can watch the DVDs and web series online. Netflix know that slowly people are moving online. Internet is playing very important role in the life of people. So what Netflix did, Netflix moved online. They make a digital platform and there they uploaded all the web series and movies, and people who subscribe for Netflix can watch movies and web series. And today we all know that Netflix is number one in digital service, digital media service provider. Netflix successfully implemented change management to meet the needs of the customers that would begin to watch content online. At one stage, it was at crossroads when its long-term sustainability was dependent on how it managed the change to a digital future. So, Netflix successfully implemented the change from delivering the DVDs at a doorstep to bringing the people to online. And today we all know that we all like to watch content online only. No one watches content through DVD or movies through DVD. So Netflix successfully implemented the change, and the result we all know that Netflix is in number one position. Now let us take another example of Domino's Pizza. Change implemented by Domino's Pizza finally saw the brand lift its sales over the Pizza Hut over the very time. Using savvy marketing, creating ordering methods and innovative technology, things were finally looking positive in 2010. Much of you all know that especially in India, Domino's Pizza is number one. Domino's has beaten Pizza Hut. Domino's has come on number one position. Now, if I talk about back in 2008, Domino's Pizza was struggling as the stock had hit all time low. Despite the importance the business had put on maintaining a positive brand image, its struggling were making this a real challenge. In 2018 was a struggling period for Domino's and their survival was also very difficult. But Domino's used savvy marketing, creative order methodology, innovative technology, and things were finally turning positive. Things started finally turning positive in 2010. In 2012, however, Domino's Pizza was back on its feet due to a successful change management implementation. In 2012, the Domino's Pizza was back on its feet due to successful change management implementation. The brand implemented new technology to support the change. A new customer delivery vehicle with a whole heating oven was introduced. The brand ramped up its digital efforts as well to meet customers' demand. Text messages, Google Home, Twitter, Facebook, Smart TVs, they were all methods used by customers to order a pizza. So, bachcho, Domino brings that new technology. As we all know, when we order a pizza, the pizza took around 30 minutes to come at our home and the pizza gets cold. But the Domino's introduced a new delivery vehicle with a heating oven. So the pizza which comes to your home is hot pizza. Domino's also started taking order through text messages, Twitter, Facebook, smart TVs. They all methods used by customer to order a pizza, and these all were effective for Domino's. In 2012, Domino's Pizza was back on its feet due to successful change management implementation. Coca-Cola. We all know about this drink Coca-Cola. We all have consumed Coca-Cola. Perhaps no organization has been through change management challenges quite like the Coca-Cola company. One example is from 1980s, when bitter rival Pepsi started to aggressively target Coca-Cola. But in 1980, Coca-Cola and Pepsi both were at cutthroat competition. Pepsi was at the height of their success and Coca-Cola was very down from as compared to Pepsi. In this response, the latter, which Coca-Cola, released a new Coke, a sweeter version of its classic drink. New Coke was not as successful and did not appeal to the public. Coca-Cola wasted no time in replacing it with the older formula. So the sweeter version which the Coca-Cola had introduced was not successful and people did not find appealing. So Coca-Cola, without wasting any time, replaced it with the older formula. Here, the brand was able to respond quickly to customer preferences so that the product's appeal was maintained. It even stretches as far back as World War II. So, Coca-Cola in World War II offered three drinks to soldiers. Coca-Cola quickly marketed itself as a symbol of the US war effort because they were offering free drinks to the soldiers. At the same time, it boosted brand recognition in designation country that Allied forces were occupied. During this process, Coca-Cola cemented its presence through 64 extra manufacturing sites across the world. This accelerated the company's post-war global expansion strategy. So, bachcho, these were some real-life successful examples of change management. Now, I'm sharing another PPT with you. What are change management models? Bachcho, there are three types of change management models and you can choose any of the three types of models. Number one, Porter's change management theory. Porter was a person who had developed this change management theory. That's why the name is Porter's change management theory. Now, what Porter's change management theory tells you? Number one, increase the urgency. Create a sense of urgency among the people so as to motivate them to move forward towards the objective. For example, you have to create a sense of urgency among the employees, among the people, so as to motivate them to move forward towards objective. For example, my company is manufacturing mobile phones from last 10 years. Now you all know that people look for the mobile phone with very good, very smart cameras. People nowadays want smart phones with amazing high resolution cameras so that they can take the photos and post it on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter and other social media sites. So it is my company manufacturing mobile phone from last 10 years, but camera quality is not so good. Because of that, sales has been decreased and sales is decreasing day by day. This created a sense of urgency. I told the employees that we have to work on camera now. We have to introduce very high level resolution camera in the market so that we can make our place in the market again. If you do not do it, our company will be out of the market and the employees who are associated with the company will be out of the job. So this will create a sense of urgency among people so as to motivate them to move forward towards objectives. Build the team. Get the right people on the team by selecting a mix of skills, knowledge, and commitment. You should get the right people on the team by selecting a mix of skills, knowledge, and commitment. For example, suppose I am teaching in Gambier University and I am teaching to the students of BBA. Now, university wants to start MBA course as well. So first of all, university make a team. Let me, Rajat sir will teach human resource management. Another faculty will teach cost accounting. Another faculty who has a forte of accounting will teach financial accounting. So you have to build a team. You have to select right people at the right place. Getting the right people on the team by selecting a mix of skill, knowledge, and commitment. Then get the vision correct. Take into account not just the strategy, but also creative, emotional connect and objectives. Get the vision correct. Take into account not only just the strategy, but also creativity, emotional connect and objective. You have to get the vision correct. Communicate openly and frequently. Communicate with people regarding the change. Whatever change you are bringing in the product, in the organization, in the technology, in the service you are providing, whatever change you are bringing, you should talk openly to the people. You should talk with them frequently so that if they are facing any problem, you can solve that problem. Because if your people is facing the problem, definitely that problem will go to affect the final product. So you should communicate with people regarding the change openly and very frequently. Get things moving. Get support, remove the blocks and implement feedback in a constructive way. Whatever feedback you are getting from the people, you should support them. You should remove all their problems and implement feedback in a constructive way. Focus on short-term goals. Set short-term goals and achievable parts in a good way to achieve success without too much pressure. But so you should set short-term goals and check time on timely basis whether you have achieved that short-term goals or not. Successfully, whether you have achieved that short-term goals or not without much pressure. Don't give up. Be persistent while the process of change management is going on, no matter how tough things may seem. But so whenever you bring any change in any organization, in anything in your life, there must be some hurdles that will come in your way. But you have to stay strong. Do not give up. No matter how tough things may seem, but you do not give up, because one day it will go to make the change. You are going to be successful if you bring the change. Incorporate change. Reinforce and make it a part of the workplace culture. But whatever change you are bringing, you should reinforce and make it a part of work culture so that people get comfortable with it, so that people can enjoy it, so that people can work in the environment positively and effectively. Number two is Edgar model. What is Edgar model stands for? A for awareness, D for desire, K for knowledge, A for ability, R for reinforcement. A is awareness. Now, awareness of the need and requirement for change. Whatever change you are bringing, what is the need to bring that change and what is the requirement of change, you should be aware of that. For example, nowadays in almost all the cars, automatic gear system is coming. But your car, but you are not manufacturing any such car of automatic gear system. people nowadays like the car with automatic gear system. You should be aware of the need, but why I want automatic gear system in my car? Because it makes driving more comfortable. People enjoy driving the car with automatic gear system. So you should be aware of the change and requirement for change. Desire to bring about change and be a participant in it. You should desire to bring about change and you should be a participant in that. Knowledge of how to bring change about this change. You should have a knowledge of how to bring this change. You should have a knowledge on how to bring this change, whether I want to appoint some new persons, whether I have to give some training, whether I have to obtain some knowledge, whether I have to find new vendors to purchase the raw material. So you should be knowledge, you should have the knowledge of how you are going to bring this change. Ability to incorporate the change on a regular basis. I'll give you the example of suppose mobile phone, Apple mobile phone. Previously there was Apple iPhone 4, then they have launched iPhone 5, iPhone 6, iPhone 7, iPhone 8, iPhone 9, 10, 11. So iPhone keep bringing the change. Keep incorporate the change on a regular basis, because if it do not bring the change on a regular basis, our thing will get outdated, old, and people will just stop purchasing it. So you should have ability to incorporate the change on a regular basis. Reinforcement to keep it implemented and reinforce later on as well. But you should keep your change implemented and reinforce later on as well. Levin's change management model. What is Levin's change management model? Unfreeze. If it's model number 3, Levin's change management model. Levin was a person who had introduced a new model, change management model. And this number one point is unfreeze. The first stage of the change process is the preparation for the change. Here employers must get prepared for the change and explain to the people why change is necessary. As most people are resistant to change, this step helps to break this status quo. But for example, in Gambier University, we have launched the LMS. So first of all, the management has trained us, faculty, about the LMS. How you can upload attendance for LMS. How you can upload subject matter on LMS, how your students are going to download it, how students are going to give midterms and weekly tests on LMS. So here employer must get prepared for the change and explain to people, and then we should explain to people why change is necessary. Now students, you all know in the time of COVID how important our LMS software is. This LMS would not be there, our Gambier University would have not been as successful as today it is. People are also registered to change. This step will help the people to understand the change. We will give them training, we will motivate them so that they can accept the change happily and implement the change. Number 2, change. In this stage, the change process take place. Good leadership and effective employee communications are crucial for this step. But to bring a change, there should be good employee, good leader. For example, to implement the LMS, the Gambier University has appointed a very knowledgeable person. That person has taken the responsibility of the leader, and he explained everyone about LMS in a very simple and in a very effective manner. When we learn, when we understand LMS, we found it very simple and very effective. LMS make our work very simple, very easy. In this stage, the change process takes place. good leadership and effective employee communications are crucial for this system. Refresh. In this stage, the change has been accepted. It is the last stage in which the change has been accepted by the people. This is the time when the employees start going back to their normal pace and continue. But so, whenever we start something new, it takes some time to get back on a normal pace and routine. So slowly and slowly, when you give people training about whatever new change you are bringing, they will slowly and slowly get back to their normal pace and the things will come on routine. So this last step requires leader to make sure that the changes are adopted and used even after the change management objective has been achieved. So in this last stage, leaders will make sure that the changes have been adopted by the employees and they are used even after the objective of change management has been achieved. What my point? So three steps were there: unfreeze, change and refresh. Now, how to communicate organizational change during crisis? How you are going to communicate organizational change during crisis? Number one, explain to your employees the changes you are implementing as well as the different steps your organizational change plan includes. So you should explain to your employee the changes that you are implementing as well as the different steps for organizational change plan includes. Tell them the reason why you are implementing these specific changes and the impact they may have on their work. For example, Bachu, when I was working in Canada University sometime back, 1 year back, we used to take classes physically. We used to take all the tests physically on paper, and all the midterms was also taken physically on midterm, on papers. But one day we come to know that everything they are going to move on LMS. So the management took this thing very seriously and they tell us that why they are going online. Because cases of corona are increasing day by day and there can be lockdown anytime. So they tell us the reason why they are implementing this change and the impact they have on our work. And we took the things positively because we know it is important to move online. And Result Vision, your friend today, we are teaching online and we all are doing awesome. There is no organizational change without objectives and goals. Clearly explain to your employees the objectives that you have set and help them identify the impacts their work will have on the team's ability to reach these goals. But whatever your objective is, whatever objective you have set, you should clearly explain to your employee the objective you have set. For example, I am a car manufacturing company. Nowadays, all people like automatic cars. So I wanted my company also start making automatic cars. So I explained the employee that my objective is to make automatic car because the future is of automatic car only. People in future will buy only automatic car, and if we do not make the automatic car today, after some years, it may be possible that we are out of the market. So you should clearly explain your employees the objective you have set and help them identify the impact of their work will have on the team's ability to reach these goals. Number last, encourage your employees to ask any questions they may have in mind, and most importantly, make sure you are able to answer all their questions. Whenever you try to bring a change, you should make your employees feel comfortable whenever you are explaining the impact of change to them, importance of change to them. You should encourage your employees to ask questions, whatever question they have in their mind, because if the questions they have, they do not ask you, obviously you cannot implement the change successfully. So you should encourage the employee to ask any questions they have in the mind, and most importantly, make sure you are able to answer all the questions, because if you do not answer their questions, they will go into confusion. Now I'm sharing another PPT with you. How to improve change management process? How can you improve change management process? Number one, determine the reason for the change. You should determine the reason that why are you bringing the change. Do you make a convincing argument for the change? Set a specific goal for the change. You should set goals for the change, and you should check whether you have achieved those goals or not. Establish key performance indicators and milestones to monitor progress. You should establish key performance indicators with the help of which the change will be implemented. Did you hit milestones and achieve your desired key performance indicators according to the timeline you established? Refer to change management models. Did the change management model guide you through your specific change initiative? You should check, did the change management model guide you through your specific change initiative? Creating a change management plan and implementation strategy. Was your strategy detailed enough to serve as a helpful guide through the transition? You should create a change management plan and implementation strategy. You should think that I want to bring this change, and you should try to make a plan of bringing that change. How you are going to manage your people to accept that change. You should make a plan how you are going to communicate that change with your people so that they can take the change positively. How you are going to train them, how you are going to motivate them so that they can work happily and effectively. So you should create a change management plan and then implement the strategy. Designate change leaders. You should appoint some people who are experienced people for whatever change you are bringing, so that these leaders can support the employees and can train the employees and can boost the confidence level of employees. Pair your change leaders vocally supportive of the change and able to persuade others to be supportive. Implement change. Now you should see that whether the implementation process go as planned and stick to the timeline you established. Suppose you want to bring some change in your mobile phone, your mobile manufacturing company, and you want to bring that change within 1 year. So you should check whether the change plan has been implemented, or whether the implementation of change is going as per we have planned, and whether they are stick to the timeline you have set for them. So you should check it, gather feedback. You should gather feedback from the people and how this change has affected the employees, how they feel about it, whether they are facing any problem, and if they are facing any problem, you should try to solve that problem so that they can work happily and effectively. That will motivate them to work. That will boost their confidence level. You should gather feedback. Analyze progress and results. Which part of the progress went well and which aspect needs improvement? You should analyze the progress. You should check that which part of the change is going well and which part needs improvement, because whenever you bring any change, that is something new for the organization, and anything that is new requires some improvement. So while working, you will get to know that which part is going very good and which part needs improvement, and the part that needs improvement, you should work on that. how to build a change management plan. A change management plan guides you and your teammate throughout the transition. These six change management plans templates with help will help you build the foundation of your change plan. Number one, change proposal. Your argument why the change needs to happen. You should ask yourself that why this change needs to happen. Because of your employees, your people is going to ask. Change leaders, your vocal supporters of the change, usually senior level management and other influence leaders. Change management communication plans. You should your plan for how you will you communicate every aspect of the change of the people affected by it. You should communicate your change management plan to the people effectively and efficiently. Change management analysis. How you track the success or failure of various aspects of your change initiative. Change management tools. The tools you need to support the change, such as employee training tools, internal knowledge wikis, etc. Change management training plan. Your outline of how training will be administered. You should outline how training will be administered. So, let us make a quick revision what we have discussed today. So, I have given you some real life examples. Do you remember of Netflix, Domino's, and Coca-Cola? These were the real life examples which I have given you. I told you that the Netflix offer monthly subscription to have movie posted at their doors. In 2007, Netflix uploaded their content on a digital platform and asked people to subscribe for it. The subscriber will no longer have to wait for DVDs to come through mail. They can watch the content online. Lacks of content they can watch online. Domino's was also facing a huge competition with Pizza Hut. But nowadays we all know that Domino's is in number one position. That is because Domino's was using savvy marketing, creating ordering methods and tech innovative technology. How Domino's implemented new technology to support the teams. A new customer delivery vehicle with a heating oven was introduced by Domino's. They were also taking orders through text messages, Alexa, Google Home, Twitter, Facebook, Smart TV. So Coca-Cola, you all have heard about it. Coca-Cola was facing a cutthroat competition with Pepsi. Coca-Cola made a strategy. Coca-Cola offered free drinks to the World War II soldiers. And Coca-Cola quickly marketed itself as a symbol of the US war effort. At the same time, it boosted brand recognition in designation countries that Allied forces were occupying. During this process, Coca-Cola cemented its presence through 64 extra manufacturing sites across the world. Then, we have discussed change management models. I told you there were three types of change management models. Number one, Porter's change management model. In Porter's change management model, the steps are, first of all, you have to increase the urgency among the people so as to motivate them to move forward toward objective. Build the team. Get the right people on the team by selecting mix of skill, knowledge and commitment. Get the vision correct. Take into account not only the strategy but also creativity, emotional connect and objects. And communicate openly and frequently communicate with people regarding the change. Get things moving. Get support, remove the block and implement feedback in a constructive way. Focus on short-term goals. Don't give up. Be persistent while the process of change management is going on, no matter how tough times may seem. Incorporate change, reinforce and make it a part of workplace culture. ADKAR model. ADKAR stands for अवेयरनेस, डिजायर, नॉलेज, एबिलिटी एंड रीएनफोर्समेंट. अवेयरनेस ऑफ द नीड एंड रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर चेंज, डिजायर टू ब्रिंग अबाउट चेंज एंड बी पेशेंट इन इट, नॉलेज ऑफ हाउ टू ब्रिंग अबाउट दिस चेंज, ability to incorporate the change on a regular basis, reinforcement to keep it implemented and reinforced later on as well. 11th change management model, unfreeze. The first step of the change management model is perception, preparation for change. Here the employee must get prepared for the change and explain to people why change is necessary. Number two stage, change. In this stage, the change process takes place. Good leadership and effective employee communication are crucial for this step. Refresh. In this stage, the change has been accepted. This is the time when the employees start going back to their normal pace and routine. This last step requires leaders to make sure that the changes are adopted and used even after the change management objective has been achieved. How to communicate organizational change during crisis. Explain to your employees the changes you are implementing as well as different steps for organizational change plan includes. Tell them the reason why you are implementing these specific changes. There is no organizational change without plan, without objectives and goals. Encourage your employees to ask any question they have in the mind, and most importantly, make sure you are able to answer all the questions. So this we have discussed today. Now let us discuss some MCQs. At the end of every class, we discuss MCQs because the MCQs will help you in getting the clarity on the topic as well as your whole topic will get revised if you attempt the MCQs. So I request everyone to please attempt these MCQs. Number one, DASH is a systematic approach that includes dealing with the transition or transformation of organizational goals, core values, processes and technology. A, leadership skills. B, change management. C, innovation. E, none. Successful change management relies on A, understand change. B, plan change. C, implement change. D, all of the above. The change that you want to implement has to be clear and relevant, so people understand what you want them to do and why they need to do it. A, understand change. B, plan change. C, implement change. D, communicate change. The strategies and plans that focus on changes to ensure a project achieves the intended goal. A, organizational change management. B, project level change management. C, individual change management. D, none. Benefits of change management. A, proactively combat resistance to change. B, set clear goal for change and monitor result. C, create strategies for implementing change effectively. D, all of the above. Gradual changes that do not require major or sudden shift, such as upgrading existing technology. A, exceptional change. B, incremental change. C, pendulum change. D, none. Sudden swing from one state to another, often switching from one extreme to the opposing view or state. A, exceptional. B, incremental. C, pendulum. And D, none. Managing the change of an individual person in order to help them grow in their role or achieve specific goals. A, organizational change management. B, project level change management, C, individual change management, and D, none of the above. How to improve your change management process? A, determine the reason for the change. B, set specific goals for the change. C, establish key performance indicators and milestones to monitor progress. D, all of the above. Last, how to build a change management plan? A, change management communications plan. B, change management analysis. C, change management training plan. D, all of the above. So, bachcho, you have to attempt all these MCQs. Please, everyone, try to attempt these MCQs. In the next class, I'm going to tell you the answers. So, that you can check whether your answers are correct or not. So, thank you, everyone, for joining. Please take care, stay safe, stay healthy.